Nightfall in Minneapolis in December usually spells freezing temps, and that is precisely the case outside these walls. But we are a comfortable 72 degrees inside U.S. Bank Stadium. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Buffalo Bills and the Minnesota Vikings. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Here we go. Set. 8-3.
Here we go. D. Man left. Man left.
Four down.
First down, Herbert. And Austin Seferian Jenkins has it. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Come on, fellas.
A good start offensively. 15 yards on the game's initial play.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and then hold down their production.
Just like that. Just
I would
like
dare
that.
Say that this week in practice,
yo,
there's
yo,
a lot
faster.
Of talk about how
get it.
That was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah,
good work,
a lot of people
boy,
think
go.
The coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move.
Watch
the screen.
He's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield score. Play three of the drive now is successful. They go backwards after those two first down games. They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12.
Defense wins championship.
Here we go on second and 12. Complete to Davis. The reception good for seven. It's third down. Trust Thursday night game. I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So as you said, you shrink the playbook. Pick out the plays that work best
Bravo.
For you. You know what else you're looking for?
And ready?
Precious guys coming up for the last game. Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
Come on now, let's go.
7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down.
Set up, 60 yards.
Short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
35-yard line.
Let's go.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
Let's go.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. A second down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
Come on,
the seventh play now,
base.
This opening drive. This is third and long, though.
Tight left. Four down.
Sit up. Deep grip.
From the gun. Herbert. Got him in. Up and that's Devontae Parker complete. And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And the Bills' opening drive yields three. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the seven they wanted, but they'll take the three.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game.
Here we go.
That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the three.
Yeah, they had three first downs and 3 points.
Let's go now. 60 Outlaw.
The mic. Man, I got you.
Now.
They'll run on first down. It's right. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Here we go, here we go.
Last one got nine. That leaves them with second and a yard.
Long day. That's going to be a long day. You go tight.
And I...
It's right. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30.
You got it. You
That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down.
Ready, ready. An
extra defensive back here for the Bills on third down.
Here we go.
61.
And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line.
That's
it's
it.
A gain of
That's
five
it.
On the play. Big It'll bring up a fourth down.
Fourth and short, partner. I mean, this would be a really risky call. Here we are in the first quarter.
On their own side of the field.
Side of the field. But boy, what a tone setter that would be to go for it and get it, wouldn't it?
You're ready today.
I'm feeling it.
12 yards on the return that time.
Let's go.
And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10.
On the ready.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. They go play action on first down. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
And go.
Intercepted,
baby, all day.
They bought
all
the house
day.
That time on a young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly. And that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
Check.
Pilot, 64, weak. Get it.
Throwing on first down. Right. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
In this situation, it's really tough to figure out how to defend because they have plenty of room to still take deep shots at the end zone as they just did there. Yet at the same time, you've got to be ready for the short throw. In this case, when you see the cue that they're going for the end zone, retreat and make sure you have a way to play forward, back towards the receiver, and have a chance to get the ball away as they get there.
On second down now, it's Light. They'll get the first down and more inside the truck. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. A great effort there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. Vecchio good on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead.
Makes the score Vikings 7.
Now after the touchdown, it's Lachlan Edwards to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line.
Got it.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And last time was a pretty one play and interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see them throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first.
We got this.
See what happens. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down.
On the double.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Ready.
Off play action. Over. For a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Brandon, so, old offensive coordinator.
Good job. Ready.
I'm going to use aggressiveness against them as this game goes on.
Right here. Go.
Back to throw. Over. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Isaiah McKenzie that time. And it's third down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we saw.
Interestingly, that throw was personally through the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
Oh, yeah!
Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
And, partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
Nowhere to go that time. It's a 46-yard punt with a loss on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
Ready, ready.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they're hoping to redo their efforts.
Into
the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because
and a big loss here as he's taken down. Shaq Lawson able to record his fifth sack of the season.
No.
Second quarter now from Minnesota. It's the Vikings in possession of the football as they've got it with a second down coming up. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
Down.
Now then after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23.
Kill! 22 Jet Bomber! 22 Jet Bomber! Hey, exit! Now!
And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line.
Fellas, they
no gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up.
It's third down. Let's get it!
Ready?
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. Operating from the gun. It's going to be and he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
They're certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
This is taken at the 23. And that's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And that will come the offense as they take over.
Ready?
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Get up here to the points per drive ratio. That answer is one.
And
that's not going to get it done in the ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
12 yards that time. The Bills first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to power through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them.
Given 5 on the carry there, it'll be second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run. Sets up a very manageable second down. Solid gain on that play.
They will find Davis. That's complete. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown.
Let's go, let's go.
Corey Davis. His fifth touchdown now on the year.
Touchdown, baby.
And the Bills have retaken the lead. He found the seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really tough because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
You ready?
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get
anything.
They're deploying deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule.
field. Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Looking to throw. Barnett. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 17 yards, first down, Vikings.
First down. First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
Come on, set. 10 Tucson.
Hey, they're scared. They're scared.
X3. 218. Chopper.
Rush in. Rush in. Rush in. Out, 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 out.
Hey, Delta.
49.
Ready, ready.
On first and 10. Barnett dancing to his left. And he's wrapped up. Taken down, back at the 25.
Hey, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Let's go now.
After the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13.
You think you're going to get this? You think you're going to get this?
Let's go.
A bit as this time they're able to get him.
Oh, yeah.
That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. First down sack, second down negative rushing play.
And I will guarantee you right now the head coach is weighing in on his headset to the offense coordinator, whether he thinks it's strategy or he thinks it's execution, because that's going to determine this next play call.
60 Outlaw.
Are you staying with what you're doing, or are you going in a different direction?
Kill, kill, kill.
Gone, gone. Go.
Throwing on third and long. Barnett. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Of course, they had the option and they choose to not take the penalty.
They like the results of the play that they just ran and they elect to let them stand.
Ready, ready.
So the special teams penalty costs some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. From the gun. Isaiah McKenzie hauling it in. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Let's go.
Boy, he ran free there after the catch as that winds up going for 38.
Let it break.
The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10.
Snap.
That run into a cemetery. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
Well, I was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out
Take
of it.
Game.
So those defenders didn't rally into the football pretty quickly.
Come get some. Come on here. Come on.
From the midfield strike, he'll make the throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. And I'm going to go back to the first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up this weekend. Call it a gain of four, but not enough. The punt team going to need to be summoned here on fourth down. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
Set.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And there are parts of their last half they like to end on. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get around the field.
Yeah,
unfortunately for them,
one
thing that matters is once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
9 yards to go.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Check, 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 13, check, 13, check, check, lucky, lucky, lucky.
He's crashing.
Rock, rocket, rocket. Fire.
Back to throw. Barnett. He's going to lock one deep left side here. And that's caught inside the 30. Have once again taken the lead. So a nice touchdown pass for the rookie there. And, you know, as they go down the stretch, look, they're not a playoff team. This is just confidence building and growth time for him, right?
Yes, the game is every team wants to win all games on their schedule. But the development of this rookie quarterback is paramount for this team. So you're exactly right. Every rep, doesn't matter what the game, what the situation, what the score, valuable for him, valuable for his team as they look towards next year.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Bills come 70, to the line to start Indy. Their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, I figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
Remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and grab a couple of sixes. Back to back, what a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football.
Ready.
So quickly,
eight,
all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Ready, ready.
Operating from the gun. Herbert, and he finds Parker here, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Let's
12
go.
Yards that time, and a Bills first down.
First down. Yeah,
this quarterback 50, now, 9 of 11 passing in this first half.
High
He's
seven.
Got his guys in first and 10.
By 10. Here we go,
complete. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action.
Let's go.
6 yards
60 Pittsburgh.
The last completion, so here's second and
hey,
four.
Hey, box drop, box drop. Go.
Second and four.
Squeeze, up.
Incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
For Corey Davis. Incomplete.
Come on,
now
set.
They face a
60
third
or.
Down and four after that incompletion on second down.
Lee Griffin, Lee Griffin.
From the gun, Herbert. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout. If they hurry, we'll see.
Let's go now.
It's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break.
Who there? Who there?
Right. Now.
So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out. Well, they've already allowed three sacks in this first half. Now a holding penalty.
So I think drastic measures had to be taken, right? The regular way was not working. He was getting hit almost every snap, it felt like. They had to try and keep him upright.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. It's a 36-yard attempt. And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. So a very tight first half. We head to break in a one-point game. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Ready.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you turn that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into the playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Here we go.
See if they do just that. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Barnett. That's caught by the tight end, Irv Smith Jr. That sets him up for third down.
They gave up the completion there. This
ready,
is
ready.
What defense is counting on.
60 Outlaw.
Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
From the gun on third down. Barnett. Rush coming and he's taken
they
down.
They can't stop us.
Sees me
they
there,
cannot
friend,
hold
momentum.
Us down. We're going to keep getting sacked.
Teams in this game.
It's only going to grow after that sack. And now, heck, they can get the ball back here and possibly even get the lead. Now Edwards to kick as he sends it away. Fielded just inside the 20. Give him 11 yards that time on the
that's
return.
That's it, baby. We got one.
At their own 30-yard line.
Here we go.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though.
Get
some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot.
Let's go! Most
of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. From the gun, Herbert. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. A gain of
that's
six
it,
there
baby.
On the first.
Set, ready?
6 yards
90
was the pick up on the last completion, so here's second and four.
Watch the pass.
Shoot.
They'll give this to Singletary running right. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run
the
football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
Ready?
On first down, they still receive the tackle. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Tackle made by Eric Kendricks.
That didn't appear to be a run once he just started it once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
15, Lonnie.
15, Lonnie. You.
Now flags will come in. One of the Bills got going a little early. That's going to set them back 5 yards.
Ready
and
up.
And that false start penalty is certainly not helping their cause
defense.
Here. Second down and long. Singletary on the toss play. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Yeah, that was a safety that came through and made the play, but there's no doubt
down.
In my mind.
Ten
he
logo.
Hits like a linebacker. We see a
pass.
Lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed.
We got.
And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Corey Davis with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year, as his guys are able to regain the lead. Well, with that touchdown pass, I'm going to bring up a point from earlier in the year. Some of the fans were saying, when do we turn to the rookie? Well, he's looking pretty good right now.
Yeah, I love the fact that
on the Reddit,
the fans are bringing that up. Because
let's make these babies cry all the way back home.
So he's got to deal
with
the way their season is going. I think
the Vikings after him, and they get there for the save.
Boom! That's how we do it, baby!
And end up getting none because the quarterback had nowhere to go with the ball.
Nowhere to go at all. Great job, though, defensively. They were ready. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he'd taken a knee.
Let's go.
At the 21-yard line.
Got it.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And
they're coming
off.
Hey, what was that?
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well, and maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
On the
from the 21, it's second and 10.
Here I come. Watch out.
Now again, right side.
Run.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback on the expected passing situation.
70, Indy. Clear.
Big Sears right here.
Hit it.
Run. It's a big one there for the Vikings. 41 yards. That right there, a good sign for a team that's had trouble converting third down so far this year. They're the bottom five in the NFL, but they come through there.
Yeah, and I bet if we put our guy Marvin on the case and say, Marvin, tell us where they rank on third and what, right? I bet they're in the top five in the league on third and five, third and six, third and seven or more, because that's how you end up not converting.
Eight,
just too much yardage to pick up on third down.
How about that for a change? All the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second.
Here comes
and
four. The boom!
And then we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Ready.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
I got him.
Joker.
Get it.
This won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two.
Third and one.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Let's get it to Recon, 132 fighter. Five.
He will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. Kicks on the pick up there, and it moves his sticks.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Off the play fake. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Boom!
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Come on,
pass protection has been a problem
Pittsburgh
all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
Ready?
Second and one. He gets this one to Boyd. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. They'll wind up getting Tim back as that sets him up for third down.
This is more where I came from.
Gets on, baby. Gets on.
Let's go now.
It's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive.
Push him back. Push him back. Watch twist, watch twist, watch twist.
Twist, twist. General West. Let's go.
Operating from the gun. Barnett looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. Out there now, the lefty Tavecchio for the Falcon field goal. From the right hand. The kick by Tavecchio is good. And that will cut the lead down to just two. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give them confidence and let them knock it through.
Here we go, here we go.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive.
Marcus, defense, Marcus.
Let go.
Now first down. It's caught by Davis. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football.
Let's go.
Shy of the 30 to the 29. 12 yards that time, and a Bills first down. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. It's been a good one so far. Just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four.
Ready, ready.
Both teams working 30 on a base. Short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen.
And he's left, Griff. Lee Griff.
First down. It's Collins. Sean Davis that time on the tackle. Offensively with the lead. You want to run the ball, keep the crowd going. But
60
you
outlaw.
Also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that? Come back on your heels.
They got all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this.
Come on,
they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time
Gator.
On the clock.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
Get him, boy! Get
no gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Brings up second and 10.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
Hit it!
From the gun, Herbert. This one caught by Davis. Yeah, he will go out right near
good
the
35-yard
line.
Let's go.
First down there on a pickup of 25. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. Sometimes they get locked into such a group and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that group right now. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball.
Come.
Second down, six.
Get it!
They go right back to Singletary. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
So many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Down. The Bills on third down. Line. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and five. Looking to throw. Herbert. Now he's going to be taken down. Better in the 35-yard line.
On these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
So points so crucial in a tight game like this, but this kick off the goalpost, and that'll keep the score right where it is.
Yeah, wouldn't have made this a two-score game, but any cushion this late definitely would have helped. Now they need to ask their defense for another stop, and that's going to require some work.
Vikings now to start their next drive.
But you gotta love what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas,
yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting off field only giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
And now is second and 10 again from the 41. Right,
let's go heavy. Let's go heavy. Everyone's
ready.
To throw again.
What you got, heavy? Give me some. Give me some.
And Diggs has it. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. Now the old pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now, with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take care of the ball in open field, sometimes the fighting for extra yardage doesn't work as a result.
And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot. He'll stop him about a yard short. Give him 8 yards on the carry, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
It's fourth down.
Break. One score down.
Guys.
Here
Mike,
go.
49.
They're going
to
go for it here on fourth down.
I'm about to take you to school.
61. Matchbox lights. They go.
On fourth down. And he will have first down yardage.
Here we go.
As he's
here we go.
Down at the 41.
Here we go.
Give him credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there.
Come on,
this quarterback
set 50,
now,
plant.
Perfect since the second half started. 7-7.
Deep grip.
They run the counter. Right. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
That big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Ready to break.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. 2 minutes
coming
remaining,
in,
and that's our score differential as well. 2 points here in the fourth quarter.
Let's go
so
now.
Vikings
60
in possession of football as we
rebound,
get you reset.
Rebound.
And let's see what they've got offensively after having time to knock it over. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll lead
easy
them
work.
To the third
it's
and about 4 more.
Coming again.
For first.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Ready, set.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball.
Inside the 30. 10 yards, and it's good
Let's
for a
go.
Viking
Do
first
it.
Down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation,
you
should be
go.
In no hurry to run a play really
or.
Fast. Let the clock wind down.
Sit up. Hit it.
First down. Right. Down he goes at the 23. A pickup of 4.
Your trip is here,
now,
baby.
The Bulls are going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Ready.
Pick up a 4. Here, second and 6.
I'm coming.
Pilot, 64, weak.
Going to give this time to the takedown. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he will score. Touchdown. A great play there in the final minute. And they have taken the lead in the final minute. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And the lead is up to 5.
Makes the score. Vikings 24.
Now after the touchdown, it's Lachlan Edwards to kick it away.
go, baby.
At their own 25-yard line.
Here we go.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. One possession game.
They should be somewhat relaxed, and I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation, but this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds to keep the drive going, and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring?
And this is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Austin Seferian Jenkins with time running out. And they have taken the lead here in the final minute. Might be said ready on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing more impressive preaching that to your team and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line.
Let's go.
At their own 17-yard line.
Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one. Whether you're able to get into field goal range, or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten.
Let's go.
Back to throw. And he's taken down. Back at his own seven.
Whoa, that's what I'm talking about.
Tonight's